Thinking about many of you being from Orlando, we thought we would speak your language. So I give you the McKee family welcome, Disney style.
Bonsoir, nos invités. Nous voudrions que vous vous préposez.
Nathan.
Et assisez.
We're going to do this in English.
Oh, I was running out of words. Except I didn't say boudoir.
It is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure
that we welcome you tonight.
And now we invite you to relax.
Let us pull up a chair.
As the family presents...
Jessica!
Be her guest, put her service to the test. Look around and see the decor, we know you will be impressed.
She can cook, she makes sweet tea,
and yum, that's fine with me.
Try her baking, it's delicious. Don't believe me,
wait a
ask
minute.
The dishes.
Baking, listen, home baking is not necessary for a modern bride. I have a few items I'd like to show you. I have a fine selection of products here that you might be interested in. We have zebra cakes. We have powdered donuts. Oh, wait a minute. Hold the script, please. This is our new line called Camp Little Debbie. I just know that Norm Midag and his family would love a product line themed after summer camps. And for each of you, a special prize for $4 tonight. Buy a lot. I need to pay for this wedding.
She can sing, she can dance, and she's even been to France.
And her cookie dough is never second best.
We've got a lot to say, and this could take all day.
Cause she's the best.
She's the best.
You know, Jessica, like many fourth children, was kind of a surprise. You see, I just had a spinal surgery.
Jessica was a blessing to the family. She brought balance to our family. She was sweet, beautiful, loved Jesus and horses, and had bright red lips and giant eyes.
Being the last child did have its advantages, though.
Yeah, she had an iPhone and a horse when she was 14.
Oh, yeah. Guys, come on. Yeah. You had it pretty good.
Well, let's take a look at the day in the life of Jessica before she got married, and she now has all these wifely duties. Get ready to do a lot of laundry. Yes, little sister, I think marriage you'll enjoy.
Hey, wait a minute. We've been talking a lot about Jessica, but I feel like we need to let everyone know what we feel about Scott.
That's exactly right. As the men in Jessica's life, it's our job to assess the suitability of his character.
Exactly. I mean, what makes a noble man? Strength, honor, intelligence. the ability to use Microsoft Excel. Let's get down to business to assess the one.
She's my youngest daughter. Will he become a son?
We're the toughest bunch he's ever met. And you can bet before we're through, Scott Brownlow will see the man that's in you.
Be a man.
Scott's a great guy. I think he's interested in politics.
Really? Why would you say that?
Well, you know, he's always spending time with the Collegedale police. Remember on their second date, they parked in that grassy lot behind the police station and an officer came over to visit?
No. That was their third date. The second date was when they went to the cemetery after dark. The police came then, too.
Be a man.
You know, they looked so much alike. Blonde, good-looking, big eyes. Do you think that's sort of odd?
Well, not necessarily in Tennessee. People marry their siblings or cousins here all the time. I mean, look at you and Jordan. You guys married someone with the same last name.
Be a man.
I knew that Jessica was falling really hard for Scott when they came back from that 60-mile bike ride from Cahuta Springs.
Why would you say that? Jessica has always been very athletic.
Well, yeah. It was snowing.
Be a man.
Now you take my daughter for the rest of her life.
In her you saw virtues to make a lovely wife. But her emotional needs, I'm telling ya, are much different than a dude. Scott Brownlow, she'll make a husband out of you. Talk about her day demanding your attention.
Better schedule in an hour or two.
It's a rigorous process getting ready for the day. The blow dryer did I mention.
The important thing is that she's in love with you.
Be a man.
He must be swift as a Kawasaki.
Be a man.
With all the force of a strong net present.
Be a man.
With all the strength of a Spartan warrior.
Mysterious as the coming
honeymoon.
Wait, mysterious honeymoon? I thought they were going to Hawaii. Well, Janelle, I think Scott has been a very worthy suitor of Jessica. Don't you think?
I agree. Wait. I can see what's happening.
What?
They don't have a clue.
Who?
They'll fall in love, and here's the bottom line. Our trio's down to two.
Oh.
Now we're empty nesters.
No more kids to raise.
And now that we have all this free time,
it's back to the good old days. Wow. You know, wow. It's going to be just the two of us in the first time in...
forever.
Because in the first time in forever,
we'll get a table just for two.
For the first time in forever,
it will be just me and you.
Don't know if we're elated or terrified,
but we're somewhere in that zone.
Because in the first time in forever,
we will be alone. Aren't they so cute? All fancy free. But do they remember I've moved back to Tennessee?
That's true, you mean so well, but leave them be.
Yes, let them think that they're alone and free.
Just think of all the time I'll have for me. Actually, you won't.
What do you mean we won't?
Got the feeling you forgot.
What have we forgot?
There's one more new family member besides Scott. You see,
you've got Brian and I and baby Jack living with you for the next couple weeks, and honestly, you're not gonna have any free time or any sleep. Sorry.
Instead of four kids, we'll have eight.
Scott and Jack added to the family tree.
We'll have so much fun.
This will be so fun.
A new son-in-law. Oh, that's great.
Our good times have only just begun.
French,
no emptiness. This is the best.
We can face this thing together. The more family, the better.
Scott, welcome to the family. You're our brother now.
She's pretty special, and I know you'll take great care of her. Congratulations on your new life together.
She's priceless.
They'll be in a new world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, lovebirds, now when did you last let your heart decide?
Because now you've got to think about two hearts when you make decisions.